Pinocchio is making a fool of himself. Now that's an interesting thing, you know. Human beings blush. In fact, if I remember correctly, the name Adam, you know, like Adam and Eve, is related to the capacity to blush. Now, that comes from something I read a long time ago, and that might be wrong, but Adam does manifest shame in the sight of God, so there is a relationship there. But anyways, people do make fools of themselves for public display, and you can tell you've done that in some sense, not always, if you blush, because you've either said something you shouldn't have, and, you know, you realize that, which is more like you've tried to be funny and gone a little bit too far, and sometimes that can be really funny, or you've said something that you know to be false, manipulative, deceitful, beneath you, any of those things, and you'll have an automatic response to it. You'd be ashamed and blush. And one theory about that is that you can trust people who blush. And so, because you know that their conscience will betray them. And so that even if they are lying, they tell you. And so, it's an interesting theory, you know, because blush is definitely, like, it's a facial display, you know, it's right out there where people can see it. So, you know, maybe that's true, maybe it isn't, but it's kind of an interesting idea. Anyways, the cricket is not happy with what's going on. He's not happy about Stromboli, and he's not happy about the willingness of Pinocchio to make a fool of himself to support this false celebrity. And so, I actually think that's why the celebrity types like that often get narcissistic and arrogant. You know, it's because they aren't paying attention. They're not paying attention really to what's happening inside of them. They drown it out because the glory and the money and all that is so attractive and enticing. They don't notice, they refuse to notice what price they're paying for it, and they magnify up their grandiosity and their arrogance to keep that stuff all under control. And then of course they get surrounded by sycophants, which is a really bad thing, right? They get surrounded by people who will tell them exactly what they want to hear. And that's really bad if what you want to hear from other people is not good for you. To surround yourself with people who won't offer you genuine criticism or even genuine reward. It's the same thing. Like, you want from me that I differentially reward and punish you in approximately the way that the good part of the crowd will. That's what you want from all your friends. Because then your interactions with them can generalize out to the broader community in a productive way. And so a good friend, you know, I mean, your friends tend to be on the supportive side, and perhaps that's appropriate, assuming there's reciprocity. But a good friend will also tell you when, one way or another, when your behavior is starting to tilt in a direction that's going to make you unpopular with them and likely unpopular with other people.